Your heart starts before you do. And it keeps up with everything you do. Let's find out how your heart does it. The heart is the main organ in the circulatory system. The best way to learn about the human circulatory system is to compare it with something else.
How about comparing it to the circulatory system of a frog?
Swell!
The structure or anatomy of the frog is very similar to the anatomy of a human. Both human and the frog have the same kinds of organs and systems of organs. The frog's anatomy, however,
is much simpler.
Both have a circulatory system consisting of the heart, a muscular pump to move the blood, a connective tissue of liquid plasma and cells, and blood vessels, arteries, capillaries, and veins that deliver blood to all tissues, which together provide a continuous flow of blood to the body, supplying tissues with oxygen, nutrients, and hormones, and facilitating the removal of carbon dioxide and waste products.
Both frogs and humans have specialized organs for the exchange of materials between the blood and the external environment. Organs like the lungs and intestines add materials to the blood, oxygen and nutrients, and organs like the lungs and kidneys remove materials from the blood and deposit them out of the body, waste like carbon dioxide and urine. The circulatory system works closely with the respiratory and digestive systems.
Both the human and the frog have closed circulatory systems, meaning that blood never leaves the network of blood vessels. Valves prevent the backflow within the vessels. Therefore, blood moves in one direction. In an open system, blood bathes the organs directly with oxygen and nutrients. Both also have a double circulatory system, meaning that there are separate systems of pulmonary circulation, which is a loop through the lungs where the blood is oxygenated, systemic circulation, which is a loop through the rest of the body to provide oxygenated blood. All creatures with lungs have a double circulatory system. Both the human and the frog have a pericardium, which is a protective membrane surrounding their hearts.
So what's the difference?
The human heart consists of the right and left atrium and the right and left ventricle, and therefore has four chambers. The frog heart consists of the right and left atrium, but only has one ventricle, and therefore has three chambers.
Another important difference between the human's and the frog's circulatory system is that in the human system, oxygenated blood is completely separated from deoxygenated blood, and in the frog system, it is not. In a human, the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from the body, and then the blood passes to the right ventricle to be pumped to the lungs, where it becomes oxygenated. It then returns to the left atrium and is passed to the left ventricle and is pumped to the rest of the body. This is a very efficient system, which provides the active human with all the oxygen that it needs. In the frog, the oxygenated blood flows through the left atrium like the human, and the deoxygenated blood flows through the right atrium also like the human. The only difference is that the two types of blood flow to the same ventricle and are mixed. Then, the blood exiting the ventricle is diverted, some to the lungs and some to the body. This is an inefficient system, but is sufficient for the frog's needs. This is a picture of normal adult human red blood cells that do not have a nucleus. This is a picture of nucleated red blood cells, meaning that the blood cells still have a nucleus.
In adult humans, mature blood cells have no nucleus. This allows more room for oxygen in the cells. In frogs, the red blood cells contain a nucleus, which takes up space, meaning less oxygen in each cell. Having nucleated red blood cells further limits the frog's ability to efficiently move oxygen through its body. Humans are warm-blooded, or homeothermic. The human circulatory system helps to maintain body temperature by transporting heat and achieve thermoregulation, or body temperature maintenance. Frogs are cold-blooded, meaning that they are about the same temperature as the air. Cold-bloodedness works for frogs because the body temperature influences growth and egg formation. Because frogs can't control their body temperature, they hibernate if it's too cold or estivate if it's too hot. In these states, their metabolic rate goes down, so they burn energy at a much slower rate. Some frogs in the far north can actually freeze solid. When cold weather approaches, they just burrow under the forest floor's leaves and debris. And when freezing weather comes, much of the water in their body goes out. Its veins fill with an antifreeze-like mixture of sugars and sugar alcohol. And then the somewhat dried-out frog simply freezes. While it's frozen, it's hard, and ice forms around the frog's organs. However, the frog's individual cells remain unfrozen and intact. Of course, when it's frozen, it doesn't breathe, nor does its heart beat. In humans, shock causes tissues to fail to receive enough oxygen. To cope with the problem, arterioles constrict and shut down the capillary beds, except those in the brain and heart. This reduces the volume of the system and helps to maintain normal blood pressure, kind of like hibernation or estivation, except humans can only do this for a short period of time without being treated. In conclusion, the similarities and differences between the human and frog circulatory system help us to better understand how we function. This movie is dedicated to all the frogs that had to be sacrificed for the sake of our education. Thanks for watching!